Satellites. It's hard to overstate how much our modern world relies on them. With commercial space companies making rocket launches more affordable by the day, and nanotechnology giving us CubeSats you can hold in your hand, we are entering the golden age of satellite technology. But just as we gain a new benefit with each new object we place in low Earth orbit, we're also adding to the odds of a collision. This danger is called the Kessler syndrome, and it was highlighted in the film Gravity. When objects traveling at 17,000 miles per hour collide, bad things happen. Mainly a cascading effect of more and more collisions, creating more and more space debris. Obviously, this is a threat to the crew of the International Space Station, but if it starts to take out too many satellites, it could also significantly threaten our way of life down here on Earth. And if it gets really out of control, it could eventually make space launches completely impossible. That means no more Mars missions. Currently, there are more than 2,000 satellites orbiting the planet, and an estimated 500,000 pieces of space junk ranging in size from about a fingernail up to the size of a bowling ball. There's a lot of room in space though, and the current debris cloud isn't very dense, but there's already enough stuff hurtling around that the ISS has to change course once a month as its crew shelters in the Soyuz re-entry capsule until the threat of a collision passes. These lethal pieces of metal are already destroying one satellite per year, which is why this isn't some abstract problem of the future. Humanity is facing this now. So it's good news then that a team of mechanical engineers in Russia understands the urgency of the moment and has developed a debris prevention system that's ready for testing. Here's project leader Alex Shenko with more.
While scientists all over the world are trying to solve the debris problem, students of the University of Mechanical Engineering and I want to test a debris prevention system. The project was dubbed Mayak. It is a microsatellite, which we started to work on in 2014 and launching in summer of 2016. Once its mission is complete, Mayak will not be wandering around in space. It will decay and re-enter the atmosphere using a special pyramid-shaped braking system.
This braking system is a delicate film 20 times thinner than a human hair, and it's coated with an even thinner layer of aluminum. During orbit, it will unfold from within the satellite to slow it down. It's a common misconception that space is an airless vacuum, as there's actually a small amount of air for hundreds of miles above the Earth. But for a tiny satellite that stopped working, it would take years for this drag to slow it down enough to enter our atmosphere and burn up. But the Mayak Aero braking device should allow for decommissioned satellites to slow down much more quickly, thus eliminating them as threats to add to the space debris problem. And while deployed, the Mayak's reflective panels will also make it the brightest star in the sky, which will start millions of conversations around the world about the need to solve this very problem. Its brightness will also allow it to be tracked, so data can be gathered on how the design of the Mayak will need to be adapted for different sized satellites going forward. The team has secured a spot as a secondary payload on an upcoming Russian space agency launch. But to finish the project in time, they need to have a successful Kickstarter campaign now, which you can check out and contribute to through the link below. While some people are developing improved systems to track all that space debris, others are holding out hope for some future fix, like using lasers to deorbit or move debris. But that's not the best we can do to begin solving this problem now, which is what makes this group of unfunded enthusiasts so inspiring. So let's go help them help all of us. This episode was brought to you by one of my favorite websites, Lynda. As a viewer of The Daily Conversation, you're eligible for a free 10-day trial membership to the online learning website lynda.com through the link in the description of this video. They have thousands of high-quality video courses where you can become an expert on the engineering design software the inventors of the Mayak used to bring their idea to life, or the photo and editing tools I use to make what you just watched. Until I talk to you next time, for TDC, I'm Bryce Plank.